Someone's cursing my lord. Late night lunch. Someone's puffling my lord. Late night lunch. Someone's growing my lord. Late night lunch. Oh lord, late night lunch.
This is a post watershed production.
Very merry festive greetings to you all. As we approach the most wonderful time of the year, here's a man hoping to find himself under the mistletoe with the holly and the ivy, while hoping his chestnuts aren't roasted on an open fire, Mikey Large.
Thank you very much, Aaron. Christmas, brilliant time of year. Or is it?
Time to celebrate buying lots of stuff, eating lots of stuff. What does Christmas mean to you?
Well, to me, Christmas, it means work, really. Yeah. Christmas is great for 9 out of 10 people. Either because you get time off work, everyone loves the time off work, don't they? Or gives you an excuse to get a little bit tipsy. Or perhaps you get to see family that you don't get to see for the rest of the year. For me, I have none of those bonuses. I don't get to see any family that I wouldn't necessarily otherwise see. I don't need an excuse to go out and get pissed, and I work more over Christmas. So yeah, Christmas, what is it apart from expensive, really? I have to buy people a load of gifts, which, you know, even if I put thought into it, half of them probably they won't want. and you know, great, so I've spent a load of money on people and worked myself into the ground. Woohoo. Great. Wow, Scrooge. I didn't realise how bad that was going to sound. What about you, Aaron?
Christmas. I tend to really enjoy Christmas, mainly because I never really got out of that child mindset. I remember all the classic Christmases where we believed in certain people, when I believed in Jesus. And, of course, Santa, I mean. The excitement that you could almost explode with the excitement of a Christmas Eve night, desperately trying to sleep, and it made a nice change, not being able to sleep through excitement as opposed to stress. You're probably right, Mike.
I'm always right.
The Christmas seems to be more about crapulence, alcoholism, and consumerism these days, unfortunately. We read everywhere that that people, I mean, this is not obviously the first year this has happened. This is not something we can necessarily blame on the financial crash, but people again are going into debt paying for Christmas. Unfortunately, they're going into debt with short-term loan companies, which charge like 1,734% APR. So,
and that's a good one.
Yeah. The legal loan sharks. Do you think it's gone too far? Do you think we've got to a stage where...
Yeah. Why are we at a stage where we'll skint ourselves, get ourselves into massive debt for at least the whole of the next year, just for Christmas? I mean, obviously there are religious connotations and things like that, but it's the commercial side that skints everyone, isn't it? And if you haven't got money to buy gifts, don't buy them. Surely your family would understand, or that's what my family say to me. You know, if you haven't got much money.
Yeah, but I mean, I think the problem.
People spending money that they don't have, but also that they don't need to spend.
Have we got to the stage? Do you think it's a lack of imagination, for instance? Rather than parents being creative, buying interesting looking things from maybe craft stores, markets, making things themselves, they think that, well, actually they have to just buy everything off the advert and everything that their friends have and make everyone generic and conformist.
Oh yeah, the days where you could make someone a Christmas present are sadly in the past, aren't they? Really. Because kids these days are more demanding, probably, aren't they? They're more.
But isn't that because it's been drilled into them through television?
They're more exposed to that kind of thing these days. And, you know, I want this, I want that, I'm a spoiled little brat, get me this, you know, and it's not easy, to make it easy. Well, no, it's true. It is true.
Like, for instance, I remember at times I could be a spoiled little brat. I still remember what it was like.
I was never, you know, a spoiled little brat.
Tell me this, was there ever a present you asked for every year and never got?
Yeah, but that's probably in more recent years.
The more recent years?
No, naked supermodel in my bed. Santa always fails to deliver on that one.
Funnily enough, I found that, yeah, that Santa does fail to deliver on members of the opposite sex. But I'm talking about exclusively childhood presents.
No.
See, I mean, I asked every year. Every year I can remember, I asked for Scribble Scramble. Do you remember that? That awesome little board game with the pieces. And
yeah.
I just wanted that so much. And my cousins had it, which made it a lot worse. And I think what I would do was around about Christmas, I'd really want it, but I wouldn't. Most of the time I'd forget to put it on my list. And then after Christmas was over, I just thought, oh man, I have to remember to put that on my list next year. I want it so badly. And I went through my whole childhood and I never got it.
Well, through you being an idiot, basically.
And personally, I blame the failures of my existence on not getting Scribble Scramble.
Yeah.
But what I'm really trying to say, kiddies, is you don't have to get everything you've always ever wanted or asked for to be
a
successful human being. It's character building not to get everything you want.
Definitely, I agree with that.
Speaking of Christmas, what about a great British institution of Christmas television? Are you the kind of guy that watches the Queen's speech?
No, definitely not.
No? No Christmas specials? You know, Royal Family, EastEnders, whatever the
EastEnders,
hell.
No. Royal Family, yeah.
God. Any other Christmas specials that you can remember watching?
Not really. Because,
you know, so, I mean, there are people who you know, their whole day revolves around... You know, there are people who take their TV guide and they put little highlighters through it and, like, put out their day by what's on TV when.
Yeah, I'm proud to say I'm not one of those people.
Of course, that's not casting any disparaging implications, insinuations even, towards the characters of people who might do that.
Not at all. Nothing wrong with it.
Because, of course, families gather around the television, don't they? Because,
oh, yeah.
Because another facet of the big day is obviously crapulence. People stuff themselves to their fit to burst with food. I think I read somewhere...
No, you go on.
I think I read somewhere, obviously, we all know what the average calorie intake is, recommended calorie intake for men and women is. I think it's about just... Well, it's just under 2,000 for women and just under 2,500 for men. Apparently, the average Briton consumes 5,000 calories every Christmas day.
Wow. I have to say, I'll probably do about 10,000. That when I was ranting before about Christmas, I did miss that crucial element out, didn't I? Food.
Mm.
There's always more of it, and it's always good. And that is probably the best bit of Christmas. No, really,
and let's not forget, obviously, the centrepiece of Christmas consumption is the Christmas dinner. Now, what other time of the year would the family eat a turkey that's probably larger than 2/3 of them and last for maybe a fortnight afterwards, with all the trimmings, vegetables, probably more meat, you know, pigs in blankets, all kind of stuff. It's almost like we're partaking of a medieval feast on a banquet table, but then I guess it is only that one special time of the year.
Once a year, unfortunately. Once a year. Oh, well, that. I guess there might be other occasions.
For Mike, it's never once a year.
Easy now.
And what you forgot to say is you consume 10,000 on Christmas Day, your average is 5,000.
Thank you, Aaron. Arsehole.
Do you eat cheesy footballs? Because that's always a
favourite. I love cheesy footballs.
I can't find them at the moment. No, anyway. I need to track some down, because cheesy footballs are a must for Christmas.
A local shop that I won't name, I may be partially to blame as well, doesn't stock the cheesy footballs. What the hell? I need to see.
So anyone out there who looking for a scapegoat to crucify, Mike will happily oblige.
I need to sit in a corner and think about what I have or have not done in this case.
I'll bring the nails.
Thank you.
So yeah, obviously you eat your body weight and more in food. Slump in front of the TV. Another great facet well, I'd say a much better facet, because Christmas TV as a whole, other than the kids' programmes, I find pretty lame. One thing nobody finds lame is Christmas movies.
The following section has been removed due to copyright infringement. Sorry about that. Fight the power.
So, yeah, another, like we say, this staple family Christmas that we imagine, obviously, is stuffing yourself till you're unconscious while you flick on TV, gather around the TV to watch some rubbish. But one thing that's never rubbish is Christmas-themed movies.
Christmas-themed movies are so good.
Mike, what are your favourite movies that are always either shown at Christmas or Christmas-themed?
Well, two of my favourite movies that are Christmas-themed and shown around Christmas as a result of that. Firstly, Home Alone. What a film. Who doesn't like Home Alone? You see, you can't think of anyone. Home Alone is literally,
it is an awesome family classic.
It is
one of the few films, again, though, that the sequel probably outdoes the original.
Ooh,
really? Are you really not going to say that Lost in New York is not better?
No, I think you're... No, I think you might be right, actually, but... Home Alone's are definitely they're right up there with all time Christmas family films, aren't they? They're brilliant, because they are for the whole family, and you know, everyone can, if I can enjoy it, you know, I'm a miserable git clearly at Christmas, then everyone can.
Okay, let me just take you back a bit. Do you ever watch any of the real classic Christmas films? I think wasn't It's a Wonderful Life.
What do you mean Christmas classic?
There we go.
As opposed to fake.
What, real as in when older classics were being made? Yeah, the original classics. Frank Capra. It's a Wonderful Life. Have you ever seen that? I'm not sure if that's themed around Christmas or whether it's just shown around Christmas. For the uninitiated, it's very much on the lines of A Christmas Carol, where a good man who's been beset by bad luck.
Sorry, go on, carry on.
What? No, considers taking his own life until he's shown what the world would be like without him. So it's kind of the opposite of Scrooge, really.
Lovely, great film, Muppets Christmas Carol. Yes,
possibly my favourite story that I revisit in every form, again and again, every Christmas, and all through the year, really, is A Christmas Carol.
Yeah, but Muppets.
There's never enough interpretations.
How good was the Muppets one?
It was probably only good because Michael Caine was Scrooge.
That was good, but...
No, Muppets Christmas Carol was pretty good.
It's an awesome film. And again, family film.
And along the lines of reinterpretations, Scrooged is another favourite. Bill Murray? Don't tell me you haven't seen Scrooged. Fool.
I may have done.
Anyway, Scrooged is the 80s yuppie kind of advertising executive take on the Christmas Carol tale with Bill Murray.
Yeah, like I was saying before I was rudely interrupted, there were two films I mentioned, Home Alone, obviously, and the sequel as well. Okay, yeah. So the Home Alones.
Let's cut out 3 and 4, though. They're two of the worst films I've ever had the misfortune of seeing 5 minutes of in my life. So it's just Home Alone and Home Alone 2. The Macaulay Culkin Home Alone.
Yeah, you don't. I'm not. Unless he's in it, I'm not. It's not Home Alone, I'm afraid. Die Hard.
This is almost another subgenre, though. This is the Christmas themed action movie.
Yeah, and what's better than Die Hard?
Die Hard 2?
Die Harder. But Die Hard. Christmas,
it's
brilliant.
It's cheesy. Perfect. It's corny. It's Bruce Willis. That
it's
is
Bruce
best.
Willis. It is
with a full head of hair, full head of real hair, as opposed to synthetic hair in his later movies. Well, I mean, can you think of any more Christmas themed action movies? Because I remember a movie that I remember. Do you remember Sudden Death with Jean-Claude Van Damme?
Yes.
Yeah. Remember when he has? There's terrorists that have stormed the ice hockey stadium and they're going to blow it up as the second that the match officially ends, and within, like, you know, a split second of full time, there's an equalising goal, whatever you want to call it, that takes it into overtime. Anyway, that always seems to be played around Christmas, and I don't know whether it's actually themed at Christmas or whether it's just because it's an ice hockey rink and, you know, it's icy. But yeah, I'm not sure about sudden death. Anyway, action movies, not sure. Action heroes in Christmas themed movies, Arnie and Jingle All the Way.
What a film. What a man.
And Sinbad as well. How good is that, Beef?
Brilliant. I'm starting to like Christmas again now.
See, before movies you have to look forward to.
Before recording the show, I had a very kind of glim view on it. But
a what?
A glim? Glim? Is the glim a...
Congratulations for making up a word.
I've made up a word. I'm copywriting that.
Glim.
Glim? What did I mean to say?
I have no idea. Grim?
Grim?
Gloomy. You wanted to say between grim and gloomy, surely.
A groomy.
Have a glim Christmas, one and all.
Or a groomy one.
What about Elf? Do you like Elf, Mike? Yeah. I think Mike likes Elf.
Groomy. Brilliant.
Oh. Anyway, we it's no good talking about the myriad films that
Elf
feature.
I want to talk about Elf.
No, we don't. It's no good talk, really, including the myriad films that feature Santa Claus. So, you know, the Kris Kringle ones, the Santa Claus, anything that involves a terminally ill child being saved by Santa and what have you. We're not going to discuss that right now. Let's talk about shopping. Because obviously, what used to be a key facet of the Christmas experience, some might suggest is almost... the overriding factor now, and the factor that gets people desperate, people in debt, buying things.
It's all Christmas is to most people these days, just one big commercial event.
It's corporate wet dream, really, isn't it? You only have to mention the word Christmas for people to get into a blind panic. Otherwise rational people...
It's like snow, isn't it?
Well, yeah, otherwise rational people who are quite capable of normal thought sequences and can react to things in logical ways, all of a sudden, they become aggressive. They'll happily push a granny over in front of a speeding train to get the last toy for their kid for Christmas.
You've been watching too many films. I don't think people...
No, I've been Christmas shopping.
Yeah, so have I. I've never seen anyone push a granny over.
Anyway.
It wouldn't be funny.
But you'll laugh anyway. Let me just say, though, the most wonderful thing has happened, and that thing is called online shopping. Now, it's obviously been around for, well over a decade now as a realistic choice. But even more recently, it's such a fantastic alternative from having to put up with your antisocial contemporaries.
It's the only way.
What it means is it just, I don't know, you enjoy the Christmas experience a lot more because you're not plunging into crowds with that vice, like pressure grinding into your head, thinking, I've got, I don't know, 3 hours parking, I've got to get 3 presents for him, 4 presents for her, got to find something for Gran, maybe get something for the bloody dog. You know, it makes things a lot more pleasant. Mike, have you had any, what's the worst kind of experience you remember? Christmas shopping?
Christmas shopping is one big bad experience.
Tell me more.
I don't like it. I don't like shopping, really, let alone Christmas shopping. I don't want to walk around,
not forget, it's also... It's kind of the worst of all worlds. It's freezing temperatures. I don't know if you're the kind of person that I am, but when I walk around a shop, I go out of my way to avoid making contact with people, either talking or, touching them in any way. So, you know, I'll happily walk into a shelf to allow someone to have safe passage around me. But what really...
More for you. How many people...
Well, this is what I mean, because you get punished for being too polite, because what you end up then doing is everyone then piles round and you get trapped against the shelf. you turn around.
This has happened.
And there's
to you,
someone
hasn't
else
it?
In your grow. And before you know it, you've knocked over the shelf.
You've been escorted out by security.
Yeah, the women who actually barge you out of the way are pointing to you. And
you're such a loser. This has happened to you, hasn't it?
Maybe. And can I just say that that was not intended as a misogynistic comment. It's well documented that men are appalling at Christmas shopping.
Yeah. No, I hold my hands up. I'm awful. I am just crap at it. I'd happily give money to no, actually, I was gonna say I'd just give money to someone and say, can you do my Christmas shopping for me? But that, you know, you've got to at least put some sort of thought into getting stuff for people, I suppose. Otherwise, you might as well not bother.
Well, yeah, because then it's just an orgy of consumption and transactions.
Yeah.
Let's not forget that the purpose for the transaction is showing someone you care about them.
Yes, yeah, I know.
Because if we forget about that, then we become slaves to corporations again, haven't we? We've bought into the consumerism.
But you know everyone else has. It's hard not to when you just know everyone else has. I'm quite happy to say that this year I'd say upwards of 90% of my Christmas shopping was done online.
That's impressive.
That's a new personal best for me as well. If I can, I'll get it online. Maybe. Right, I'm going to say it's mostly, no, I'm going to say it's mostly because I'm lazy rather than the hustle and bustle. I mean, I can live with the hustle and bustle. I just don't like it.
Yeah, but let's not forget also, this isn't just a case of, oh, you're complaining because you have to walk down the road. You know, you've got to organise transport. I drive personally. That means you have to defrost your car. It means you have to pay for parking. It means you have to obviously pay attention to when, you know, how much time before you have to dash back to the car.
You have to carry it all.
Yeah, exactly. Well, this is a big issue as well, because this is the kind of thing, when you're parked up, you kind of take a deep breath and you think, I'm just going to have a relaxing time, come back with the shopping. You never think, how much is the shopping going to weigh? By the time you get back, you know, your hands are completely frozen. You're probably skidding around like on the ice ring of a car park, and you know, you're carrying the equivalent of a baby elephant in each arm. Overall, it's just a really unpleasant experience.
Thank God for Christmas online shopping.
Yeah, goodbye High Street, hello online shopping.
Indeed.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Get your stinking rat out, it's late night large.
Let's not forget that although the timing of this holiday is cynically brought in to take advantage of the fact that the pagans also celebrated the winter solstice around this time of year. But let's not quibble about the dates. This is about Jesus' birthday. The Christmas story, was that kind of a magical thing when you were a kid? The idea that three wise men followed the star?
Not really, it was just something I had to sing about at school. I'll be honest.
Did it not inspire you at all? I'm not saying
me personally,
are you a devout Christian? I mean,
me personally, did,
yeah. Did that story inspire you when you were a kid?
No.
Are you telling me you didn't believe any of that, or your little eyes lit up when you heard about the three wise men finding the lonely stable where the virgin
yeah,
birth?
Yeah, they found him and getting excited about that kind of. No, not really. I'll be honest.
Well, all I'm saying is I don't think you'll find three wise men in Banbury. Yeah, the Christmas story, anyway.
Or a virgin.
Just take it to the next step.
That's what I mean, we've got to stop.
Although you probably find a few inhabitants who were born in the barn. So anyway, the three wise men followed the star to a lonely cattle shed where, yeah, the Immaculate Conception had happened and the virgin birth. Let's face it, the innkeepers were a bit snobby. And the message, obviously, of the story is, don't judge a book by its cover. You know, yeah, open your door to the weary stranger. So if someone's in need, don't worry about how they look. You offer them a hand. Obviously,
don't worry about the state of your carpet when she's given birth on it.
Yeah,
you know.
Don't worry if they're armed or...
Just let anyone into your house.
Exactly.
But can I just say...
Go on.
Joseph,
yeah.
Right.
What did Joseph do? What was his profession? I forget.
I don't know. That's not important.
Okay.
What's important is how well he took the news. I mean, so so you wake up next to your bird, right? And she says, "Oh yeah, whatever." Well, was she told in a dream or something?
I think it was a dream. Yeah, I think it was a vision.
Oh, so she wakes up, and you know, you wake up the next morning. She's there grinning, whatever. Well, you got to be, you know. I haven't seen you smile like that in a while. What's going on? Oh, by the way, I'm pregnant. Really? Great. Yeah, it's not yours. I mean, how would you take that?
And let's not forget that, of course, Joseph would surely know it was not his, because they hadn't enjoyed sexual congress.
Exactly. So, I'm pregnant. I thought we were going to lose it together.
Yeah.
I thought that's what's going on. I thought we were waiting for the right time. I thought we were both.
Could you get pregnant from holding hands?
So, yeah. Is it? I didn't. You know. That confused the hell out of you. And by all accounts, he took it really well, didn't he? Really. I mean, I'd be out that door straight away. Oh, really? You're pregnant, are you? Virgin.
Let's face
it.
Don't lie
to me. You've been out.
Let's not just focus on that though. Let's focus on the fact that Joseph. Let's face it. He's a really interesting guy. He thinks, you know, Mary wouldn't lie to me. He trusts the fact that child is God's.
If he was around these days, now, he'd be the type of guy that gets made a mug out of daily.
He'd probably be the type of selfless guy who raises another man's child. That's it, isn't it, really? But how could... I mean, there's that male pride thing.
She's a virgin and she's pregnant. It's like, are you?
But there's that male pride thing. How... I mean, let's face it. Every guy who's ever got dumped or... I don't know, looked over for another guy. Every guy has had that feeling, that wounded pride, that, oh, what the hell has that idiot got that I haven't, and thinking, oh, he's taller, he's...
God's a bit different.
Well, that's what I'm coming to. You think, you know, oh, he's taller, he's stronger, he's more charismatic, he's funnier, he's better looking.
Got more money.
Yeah.
Better home.
Now, all of these things you can possibly overcome by embellishing your own personality and believing in yourself. But God, can you really outdo that? By the way, the Father's the creator of the heavens and the earth.
Are you aiming that at me, or because?
No, Mike, you clearly got to be in your bonnet about that. I wouldn't aim that at you.
I'm just saying, Joseph. Clearly, I'm up there with God, aren't I? Really? What were we saying about Joseph? Yeah. So she's told him that she's pregnant. She's maintaining that she's a virgin. He knows, unless she's done something to him in sleep. He knows that it's not his, but she's pregnant. I mean, how is it? Oh, no, it's not. It's this geezer called God, and he came to me in a dream, and he told me. Someone told you in a dream that you're now pregnant, and now you're pregnant, just like that.
Can I just make clear?
Would you believe it?
Well, of course not, but it was a different time, you know. There wasn't social media for one thing.
No, social media got to do with it.
Can I just say that Mike doesn't intend to be blasphemous. He's just a very cheeky chappy. So please don't take that as
grotesque
blasphemy.
I'm just saying fair play to Joseph.
He's a good man. So we were supposed to be talking about the story of Christmas and Jesus mainly, but we've ended up talking about his surrogate father, Joseph, being a top man. The big day's almost upon us.
Can't wait.
Really? No. What have you asked Santa for this year?
Like I mentioned at the beginning of the show, same thing I ask him for every year. Same thing he fails to deliver every year.
Would you like to tell the listeners what you'd like Santa to bring you for Christmas, and maybe, you know, they could pull a few strings for you?
Nothing will be getting pulled.
Mike would like to pull a cracker for Christmas.
Naked supermodel in my bed.
Please, Santa. Please, Santa, bring me a strumpet for Christmas.
In fact, all you got to do is just introduce me to one. I'll do the rest myself, Santa. Do you know what I mean? Just introduce me to a supermodel. I can do the rest. This face here, I'll tell you. Charisma.
Can you name all the reindeers?
I taught the knickers of a nun, but no, I can't name all the reindeers.
Come on. Give it a go. How many can you name?
Rudolph. The geezer with the red nose.
How many
Dasher,
rain-
Prancer, Rudolph, Dasher, Prancer, Rudolph, Prancer,
Doc, Dopey, Sneezy, Sleepy.
did I say Dasher?
Anyway.
What are they then? Come on, Bright Spark. What are they?
I don't know. Rudolph, Donner Blitzen.
Yes, yeah.
Dancer, Prancer.
Dancer?
Comic Cupid. Is that it? Comic Cupid, Rudolph. Donner Blitzen.
Dancer, how many Prancer. Are there?
I don't, there's seven. There's either seven or there's seven plus Rudolph.
I thought it was nine.
No.
I thought it was seven.
hang on a second. Let's just find this out for sure. And they are Dasher. That was what I missed.
No, I said Dasher.
Yeah, Dasher. Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen. Yeah, because they're all supposed to rhyme. And it's
Vixen,
quite,
you missed as well.
There's Dancer
and Rudolph.
Oh, yeah. And of Rudolph. Course Rudolph.
So how many?
One,
is
two,
that?
Three, four, seven. Five, six.
What's no, Donder eight. Or Donner, apparently. Donder.
There's nine altogether. Yeah, there's like nine altogether. Eight plus Rudolph.
So it's nine. I said nine. I was right again.
Before we go, is there any messages of hope or goodwill you want to send out to our listeners?
Ooh, messages. Merry Christmas.
Hope and goodwill to all men, or...
Yeah, and all that. If you see me in the pub, buy me a drink.
Brilliant, Mike. Selfless as always. I've got a few messages for Christmas.
Oh God!
Let's remember the true spirit of Christmas, people. Okay, okay. Let's remember the true spirit of Christmas. Okay, don't get into debt for Christmas. If you want your kids or your nephews or your nieces to have a great Christmas, be creative. Get them a gift that, okay, not cheap and tacky, but something. From the path less tread, or something you've made yourself, which would be even nicer. And let's not just go into the big corporations. Don't just shop at Boots and WH Smith, Tesco, and all the other giants. Let's go into independent stores. You know, support your local independent stores, arts and craft shops, little gift shops, Christmas shops. Remember to be good to each other. Okay, you play games together, you watch movies together,
spend time together.
Don't get drunk and abuse your spouse or your children.
And get
for,
drunk, though.
And for God's sake, don't drink and drive. That's the stupidest thing you could ever want to do over Christmas. So leave the sleigh at home, all right? Yes. If you're going to get rat-assed, it's Christmas. Pretty much everyone does it.
But get rat-assed and walk home and slip
walk
over.
Walk home, you lazy, lazy people. What we're trying to say is... Remember the true spirit of Christmas. No arguments. Yeah, have a safe Christmas. Just do everything in moderation.
Apart from the alcohol.
Apart from the alcohol and the food.
Yeah.
Of course, and the presents.
Eat and drink until you stop.
Until your heart stops.
Meant drop, but yeah. Or you stop.
And let's also remember to take it easy on the National Health Service, all right?
You know,
it's Christmas for them too. Don't get... pissed and fall down the stairs or walk in front of a car.
I'm sure no one plans to do that sort of thing. You know?
Well, what I'm saying is, you know, if you drink your weight in alcohol, it's more likely that you'll do something irresponsible.
I disagree. I never do anything irresponsible. And I always...
And don't glass your mates.
Yeah, that's pretty irresponsible.
Don't sexually assault people under the mistletoe, Mike. Or fire weapons into the air.
Or out of your bathroom window.
Or fire a nuclear weapon at Iran.
No, I'm going to say no.
Merry Christmas, one and all, from both of us at Late Night Large.